Anna, hi.
Hey, hi, Dallas.
Nice to see you.
Good
Thank
to
you
see
very
you.
Much for coming to chat.
Thank you.
Let's talk about hydrogen. How can we use it as part of our energy transition?
The beauty of hydrogen is that you are tackling hard-to-abate sectors, hard-to-electrify sectors.
That's interesting, yeah.
Sectors where renewable power is not going to be enough because you need high energy intensity. Aviation would be one of those. Then you have processes actually where you require a lot of heat and high temperature. So chemicals, refining, fertilizers, companies, steel, cement, all of these industries, they just cannot work just using renewable power.
Years into the future, what do you think the world would look like in terms of hydrogen, in terms of where we'll be?
I think that next 10 years are really about setting the foundation of what the hydrogen economy will look like. And then after that, from 2030 to 2040, having de-risked in business terms, the technologies, the business model, having understood how this works in practice, then we're going to start scaling it up. And today, we are really starting to see regulatory environment shifting towards this is what we expect you to do. Now, is that going to be enough? I'm afraid not, because you still need to have companies like Shell making those investments and finding the right business models. It will mean that we will have to find consumers, sectors, also starting to make investments on their side.
What do you think Shell's role is in all of this?
We have a dual role. On one side, we need to bring energy today, and at the same time, using the current energy infrastructure, and make sure that it's secure and is the lower cost. And at the same time, start building the future energy system and making it affordable, scalable, so that we can switch over time and be net zero by 2050.
Presumably, you don't do this all on your own. Presumably, there are other partners and collaborations.
Absolutely. If I think about the Holland Hydrogen One, again, it's our flagship project at the moment. We are working with 150 companies to make it happen. In addition to all the work that we've done with the government, also, they've supported us in this journey. Now, this is only on this project. We need other companies like Shell coming to invest next to us and bringing economies of scale and scale to the hydrogen economy.
What, for you, has been the big learning for you?
The last 10 years, we were wondering about, do the technical solutions exist? We are at the point where we are saying, actually, we know they exist. And now the next series of questions are they economic? Can you make it work? And are they profitable? And the second one is that you can aim for perfection, but actually you need to just move on and progress through action.
Honestly, I'm going to have that on my tombstone.